it's Jaclyn. I'm coming to you from my dining room. We are going to do some kitchen table yoga, I would like to call it today. So just something, everybody's in quarantine, to kind of get you out of your normal routine, out of your bedroom, out of your living room, wherever you're doing yoga at. The goal is to kind of give you fun options to do yoga in different places of the house. Maybe you're cooking dinner, maybe you just need a change of scenery. So today, my dining room. So what we're going to do is we're going to start, just pull out a chair. Make sure that your feet are on the ground. So if you have a countertop height or a bar height chair, try to find just a chair that you can sit, you can kind of place your feet on and really ground into the earth, okay? So from here, take yourself to the edge of your seat, take the fleshy part of your seat, move it out. Place your hands on your thighs. You can turn them up if you'd like, but I kind of like to feel my legs. I like to feel the energy flowing through them. So from here, sitting up nice and straight, fleshy part of your seat out. Place your hands in your lap, up or down. Roll those shoulders down and back. Hi, Mia. Your chin parallel with the mat. Open your heart. And just kind of close your eyes and start to breathe. Imagine as you're breathing in that you're breathing in from the top of your head, inhaling into the chest. You can feel your belly rise, and on your exhale, feel your belly contract to the spine. Feel the warmth of the breath on the upper lip. Just continue to take a couple of deep breaths here, just centering yourself into your practice. It's going to be a really short practice, something just to feel good, to feel stretched out, to feel alive. So just take a couple of breaths here, inhaling, exhaling, inhaling, and exhale, inhale, exhale. Inhale and exhale. Good. Just take a moment here. Roll those shoulders back. You can open the eyes. You can leave them closed. It's up to you. And then roll them forward. Good. Kitchen table yoga. You can do this in the kitchen. You can do this at the table. You can do this at your countertop, whatever works for you. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to stay in this chair. Hopefully you found a chair that your feet can touch the ground. If not, just prop them up and get them somewhere to where you can really stabilize yourself. So we're going to start. We're going to kind of go into that modified pigeon pose, but from a seated position. Again, we're on the edge of our seat, not all the way to the back. Let's go ahead and take that right foot, cross it over your left thigh. Now, what I want you to do from here is flex through that foot. So you can choose to kind of just let it hang out, or you can choose to engage, flex the foot. Now, your knee may be up here. That's okay. It just means that you've got some tight hips. This will actually feel really good. It's kind of like that hurt so bad, feel so good kind of feeling. So from here, we're just going to allow that right knee to kind of open up to the side. Good. So sitting here, this may be enough for you. You may need some more. But what I want you to do, I'm going to turn to the side for a moment, is with that foot flexed, I want you to sit up nice and straight. And we talk a lot about from hinging at the hips. So I want you to hinge from the hips, flat back, hold it here, okay? Just hang out here, find your breath, couple of deep breaths, inhaling and exhaling. Good. Two more breaths, inhale. And exhale, inhale, on your exhale, if you're able, I want you just to let the body go. Just fold forward and hang out here. Now that you feel that glute stretching out quite a bit, that's good. The piriformis is starting to let go. And you can rock a little bit here if you feel safe and secure in your chair. If you don't, then just hang out right here and just hold for a second. And then all we're going to do from here is we're going to take that right foot. We're going to place it into the crease of the elbow, like we're going to rock the baby. We're going to bring it up. I'm going to turn forward so you can see. And we're just going to rock. Just warming up that hip. Good. Nice rocking. Good. So maybe this is not possible. Maybe you can't interlace those fingers. Maybe you just hold on from the outside. Maybe even hold the foot and just rock. Some of you I know like to roll. Just don't roll yourself off of your chair. So if you want to roll, roll away. Don't roll too far though. Good. Go ahead and place that leg down. Sit up nice and straight. Let's inhale those arms up. And exhale, bring your hands to your heart center. Good. Let's go ahead and switch legs, okay? We're gonna take that left over that right, sit up nice and straight, edge of the seat. Good, from here, foot is flexed, nice and active. Remember, not every side is going to be the same. Maybe one side is a little bit harder than the other. Like this one, my knee kind of bothers me a little bit. So I'm just gonna back off just a little bit. Good. Sit up nice and straight, hinging from the hips. I'm gonna rotate to the side. Good. So all we're gonna do, remember, close the book. Hinge from the hips, go as far as you can. For me, this knee is really bothering me today. It's not very happy. So all I'm going to do is I'm just gonna hold on to it from underneath. I'm kinda gonna give it a little bit of a support. Now, if you're okay, then you can obviously press down into it and things, but right now, I need some help. So I'm just gonna hold it up a little bit. Good, hinging from those hips, nice flat back. We're gonna go for two more breaths right here. Inhale. And exhale, inhale, exhale. We're just gonna let it go, forward fold. Good, allow the head to hang, allow the back to relax. Feel that glute, feel that piriformis stretching out. Again, rocking if that feels good, or just staying right where you are. And then when you're ready, taking that foot to the elbow crease or holding onto the foot from the outside, we're gonna begin to set it up and we're just gonna rock the baby. Again, maybe you're holding onto the foot and the outside of the leg. Maybe you're holding on this way. It's up to you, wherever you're comfortable. Good. Just hanging out here. Good, carefully place that leg down. Let's go ahead and inhale the arms up. Big breath in. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Good. Now we're going to begin with our standing part. Again, this is just a short video just to kind of get you feeling good right when we start to get a little stiff or we're tired of sitting or doing whatever we're doing around the house. So from here, all we're going to do is we're going to step away from our table. We're going to use our table as a support. So we're gonna start into some side body stretching. So legs together or slightly apart. And again, kind of like a nice, you know, 15 degree angle off of your shoulder, okay? So place your hands onto the table, to the counter, whatever it is that you have. Inhale that right arm up and exhale, trickle over to the side. Good, using that table for support, but don't press to where that shoulder comes up to the ear. Let the shoulder relax, find length and breathe. Good, couple of more breaths. Inhale, exhale, and bring it back up to center. Good, we're gonna rotate over to the other side. We're gonna take that hand, that right hand, place it on to the table. That left arm comes up, reach up, and we're gonna take it over to the side. Again, allowing the shoulder to relax, feeling that side body stretch. Breathing here. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, bringing it back up. Good, taking it back to the other side. We're gonna go one more time, allowing ourselves just to go a little bit deeper. Inhale the arm up, and exhale, trickle over. Good, breathing here. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, bring it up. Rotate other side, finding that nice grounding through the feet. Inhale that left arm up, exhale, take it over. Breathing, relaxing the shoulders for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, bring it up. Good, so next we're gonna go into a down dog, stretching those hamstrings, and then we're gonna go even further and allow the stretch to go into the shoulders. So what I want you to do is take the hands, place them on your table or your countertop. We're gonna take a big step back, almost like we're gonna make an L, right? If I flatten my back, I'm making this L form here, okay? So step back, place your hands onto the table, and then all we're gonna do is we're gonna send the bottom back, but I want you to think long spine. So don't allow the back to arch quite yet, okay? So from here, allowing the back to lengthen, think about lengthening the spine through the tips of your fingers. So as my head comes in line with my arms, my spine is also in line with my arms. Take a couple of breaths here, holding stillness. Good. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Good. And start to wag your tail from side to side. This should feel good. If you feel really tight, you can bend the knees, straighten the legs, bend and straighten, keeping that spine nice and long as you can. And then go ahead and straighten. And this time, I want you to allow your head to drop between your arms and then arch through the back, allowing the shoulders to stretch out. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, coming up, roll through the spine. Stand up, roll out the shoulders if that feels good. Good, from here, we're gonna go into a modified chaturanga. So the tricep push-up, yes? So the lovely thing about our tables and our countertops, it kind of gives us a nice, gentler approach to it. We're building strength and we're still gonna do a good workout and stretch. So setting those feet back to where we were in that modified down dog. Feet are about 6 inches apart and they are parallel. You're gonna take your hands and they are gonna be no further than 6 inches apart as well. All we're gonna do from here is we're just gonna bend the elbows in towards the chest. We're gonna hold and extend it back up. So when we do this, try not to bend at the bottom, okay? So we wanna create this flat board position. So as we bend, flat as you can, hold and up. Make sure your table doesn't slide. Again, bend, hold, and lift it back up. Let's go for two more. Bend, hold, and back up. And bend and hold. And back up. Good, your arms should feel a little bit. You could do that every day and have some fantastic looking arms. Now, our next one that we're going to do, you can do this in different heights based off of your flexibility and your mobility. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take our foot and we're gonna place it on the table in a bent position, flexed foot. If you need to really grip on, that's fine too. So let's say you're using your kitchen counter, your counter height table, and it's too high. I want you to go back to that chair that we first started with, and this is a perfect position. So as high as you can get the leg, you can go onto it, end table, whatever works. So I want you to take that right leg and place it on the table. Good, now from here, all we're gonna do is we're gonna do a quick compression in, compress, squeeze. You should actually feel that psoas on that left side stretching out, that quad stretching out. You should feel a nice good stretch. Make sure your core is engaged here. Squeezing, not putting pressure on the knee, put it on the thigh. Squeeze, 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 and come up. And again, squeeze, 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 and come up. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna pivot. So that hip is now open. I'm gonna turn real quick to show you from the side, now go back to that right side. So all we've done, we're still activated in the foot. We've pivoted open to the side. So my standing foot can be straight or slightly turned out for balance based off of where you need. Now, modified malasana from a standing position. All we're gonna do is open the arms, pressing the arm into that inner thigh, opening up that hip. Good, if you need that chair, you can do it from chair. One-legged malasana for 5, turn back to the other side. 4, 3, 2, and 1. Then we're gonna rotate carefully back forward, go back into that compressed position. And this time, taking that left hand, holding onto the outside of the right foot, we're gonna twist over to the side. The hand can come to the lower back, it can come out to the side. You can turn it up, or you can just place it on the hip. Just a nice little twist here as we finish out this quick little practice. Good. Bring it back through center. Now what I want you to do is I want you to straighten that leg. If you're able, take the hands, place them on the table, the chair, whatever you have going for you. Good, and then from here, think about forward fold. Feeling that hamstring really stretch out here. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, come up. Carefully take that leg off, shake it out, hula hoop those hips if you need. Good, and then from here, we're gonna switch to the other side. Remember, we're trying to get that standing leg right underneath our hip if possible. We don't really want it out too far. So this time, that left leg comes to the table, to the counter, to the chair, wherever you've got it. And then we're just gonna lean forward. See, compress, so we're getting that stretch through here. The psoas area is getting stretched out. Good, big compression, not holding onto the knee. Grab that shin right there. Good, compress. Good, we're gonna begin to open up to the front. As you open, good. Now, I'm gonna show you what it looks like from a chair position. So if your foot is on the chair, obviously the knee is more in line with the hip, and all you're gonna do is just press it open, okay? It's almost like you're doing a standing tree pose instead of a malasana type pose. Good, modifying here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, we're gonna rotate back through center, reset, find that compression, feeling that stretch. And then when you're ready, that right hand holds onto that left. We're rotating over to the side, hand to the lower back, out to the side. Good, or you can keep it on the hip. Holding here for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Bring it back through center. Carefully extend that leg out straight. Hands to the table if you're able. If you're not able to place the hands onto the table, place them onto the thigh and just think about hinging from the hips and you will get that hamstring to stretch out. Now remember, flex that foot here. Breathing, almost there. For 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, slowly come up. Good, shake out the legs, hula hoop if you need. Good, go ahead and find that seat back onto the chair with me. We're just gonna take a couple of closing breaths. Many more videos to come. We hope that you guys are enjoying them. Always suggestions and feedback is always welcome. So let's just go ahead and take a couple of inhales. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, hands to your heart center. Let's leave the hands here at our heart center, fingertip to fingertip and palm to palm. And every day, in every way, you are getting better and better and stronger and stronger. Namaste.